Happy Sunday, everybody. Whatever day you're clicking on this video, I hope it's a happy day for you, and I hope that this video finds you well. And so today what I want to really focus on is creating sacred space not only within but around us. So briefly, I'll just say, if you are joining me for practice, a lot of times people are like, well, I don't have space to do yoga, so on and so forth. So here's the thing, it doesn't matter how big or small your space is, you can take a pose of your choice. You can sit still with your breath no matter where you are, okay? I definitely want to say, just make sure your space is as clear as possible, as clean as possible. So, you know, just minimize clutter, okay? If you can, no clutter at all is my suggestion. We want to create space for the good to come into our life, for us to be clear on what it is that we need, what it is that we need to be doing, and what it is that we want to do, right? So part of that is clearing your physical space. And then the practice is going to help us to clear our internal space as well as, you know, take care of this physical body. So I have a couple things in my sacred space. I have flowers here, I have stones, and I have a candle. The flowers are something to me that just signify, you know, this constant devotion to loving myself unconditionally and gifting myself with what it is I love to be gifted with. So I'm taking that into my own hands. And then my stones are, you know, depending on what things are happening in your life and what you need guidance and support with, you'll pick your stones. So my stones are here for that, just to offer me that healing guidance through the practice, and so that I activate them and just move with intention as they are around me so that they can be a source of healing as well. And then the candle is lit. I've lit a chocolate candle today. And that is something too, if you want to, you know, grab candles, whatever candles resonate with you. I love the chocolate candles. Today I lit solar plexus for power and purpose and just confidence and, you know, raising self-esteem. So of course that's very important when doing videos and just speaking to people as well, just being able to, you know, convey things purposefully and stay connected to what it is you're doing with your power. And to me, I like to use this candle to remind me to use my power for good. So we are here today, so I'm not gonna talk your ears off, but I definitely want this to be a moment where you're not only moving your body, however you're building a complete yoga practice and you're learning about different foundations that are gonna contribute to your practice and you cultivating a practice that serves you and helps you do the things that you're needing to do with your life, whether that's healing, de-stressing, just embodying more healthy living habits, whatever it is, right? Communicating more effectively in your relationship with self and those around you. So whatever your desire is with this practice, you know, this is just that time to really consider that, right? Some people like to call it setting an intention. So if you want to set an intention for today, you know, just consider why you're here. You know, what is making you click on this video, curious, and, you know, check your intention, check your heart, check what it is that you desire to have in your life, right? So I think that's also a great way for us to also show up here in this space compassionately, lovingly, and openly. So just considering what our intentions are. Today we're going to use Ujjayi pranayama breath, and it's also referred to as ocean breath or victorious breath. And this breath just allows us not only to learn how to breathe in and out through the nose more effectively, it also allows us to have more energy in our yoga practice. It's a warming breath, which is wonderful because our season is changing, right? So it just warms the body as you breathe. It's also a breath that nurtures your throat chakra. And this is your center for communication and just using your voice. Man, using your voice not only to communicate your truth, using your voice to express yourself, your feelings, you know, and to voice your needs, your concerns, your desires, your wants, okay? And, you know, to let others know how you feel and what you need as well, and do that from an authentic, loving, compassionate space we all know that this is something that for many of us needs perfecting, myself included. So I'm always looking for ways to say things, and I'm always looking for a way to get out of the text message epidemic that's going on with communicating. However, sometimes I've found that I've had to meet people where they are inside of a text message. So we do want to be able to really speak to one another, though, beyond text messages. So hopefully this practice today, this friend, helps us to find the courage to do that more often and not be afraid of the response, but to take the response as a lesson for something that maybe we need to look at inside of our communication and just the way that we're interacting with others and how even our relationships are contributing to our well-being and our healing process. And what do we need to learn? What can we learn? What can we teach, right, through our communication? So, yes, let's get started. Let's close our eyes for a second. That was a lot that I said. I hope that you were able to listen to it and find something that resonated with you on your journey to being completely well and embracing the wholeness that you are naturally. So let's place our right hand onto the throat. We can just feel our throats today. If there's anyone that's congested, feeling some inflammation in this area, so that's making it hard to breathe in through the nose, out through the nose today, I'm gonna breathe in through the mouth, out through the mouth. And we're going to pronounce hum in a whisper. Okay, that's going to allow us to activate our throat in this breath. Okay, so let's sit up nice and tall. Spine is nice and long. Move the fleshy parts of your bottom if you need to. Keep the eyes closed as you just move around and adjust. Chin parallel to the ground, right hand onto the throat. Big breath in through the nose. Hum on the exhale. I want to draw that breath out. Back you to relax your shoulders, your arms, your entire body as much as possible. Do not contract your belly on your inhales. Relax the belly. Allow it to be free as you inhale. The same breath, and this time try to gently seal your lips. Keep the exhale at the back of the throat with a hum, but the mouth is sealed gently. Thank you. consider why you're here. What is it that you need? Bring that need into your practice as an affirmation, so it's already done. And that's how we are speaking it into our intention. If you need to stretch your legs out and switch to cross, please do that. Take your time, one at a time. Okay? Shake your legs out. And then recross. Okay. Alright. Now we're going to go ahead and draw the right ear to right shoulder. Inhale. Hold here for a moment. Take a breath in. Exhale. Please stay with that Ujjayi breath. Exhale at the back of the throat. Breathe in. Exhale. Inhale, head to center. Exhale, chin to chest. Breathe in. Exhale, left ear to left shoulder. Breathe in. Exhale. Breathe in. Exhale. Eyes closed or open during this time. Inhale, bring your head back to center. Good. We're just going to make a U with our chin. So inhale over to the right. Exhale over to the left. And with your neck today, inhale over. Exhale over to the left. Keep that same Ujjayi breath. Okay? Inhaling through the nose. Exhaling at the back of the throat so that hum lips are gently sealed. Continue to move side to side. Eventually round and round as if you're drawing a circle with your nose. Maybe inhaling on the way up. Exhaling around and down. Next time the head comes to center, we'll reverse our chakras opposite direction. All the way around, exhale. Inhale up. Exhale around and down. Chin to chest, exhale. Inhale, chin to sky. Exhale, chin to chest. Inhale, chin to sky. Palms facing up or down this time. Exhale, chin to chest. Inhale, chin to sky. Exhale, chin to chest. Pretty lovely. I know my idea of that. Stretch the legs out. And then let's go ahead and come around to a position of all fours. Okay?
right foot up to the top of our mat, okay? Back toes tucked under or either pressed out. You're gonna decide which one, okay? And then you're gonna come upright here, okay? Place the left hand into the right thigh, center of it, okay? And then bring your right arm up and over. And we're just breathing in and out. These slow circles, up and around, okay? Keep your ujjayi breath. Press into the top of the foot or either the ball of the foot, whichever way you chose to angle your foot here, okay? Then we're gonna reverse our circles backward. Now, really important, if you find that this is too much for your arm right now, mobility-wise, you're gonna go ahead and bend your elbow and just circle up slowly and around. Okay? Now, we're gonna show our circles backward, okay? That's about five on each side. Bring the hands down. Go ahead and take the right foot back around. We're gonna bring the left foot to the top of the mat. Same exact thing, okay? You're gonna figure out whether or not you want to keep the toes tucked under, pressing into the right top of the right foot and the shin, or set the toes out ball of the foot, okay? Whichever way. All right, so we place this right hand onto the center of the left thigh, okay? Just keep us stable. And the right arm goes up and over. So remember, you can bend the elbow and do your circles forward really slow. Okay. Inhale all the way up. Exhale down. You can follow your hand up and around if you'd like. For your knee if you need to, you all. So you can have a towel underneath your knee if you feel any pain or heavy or too much pressure on it, okay? And then we're gonna go ahead and circle backward. Remember, you can bend the elbow on this side as well. Keep your core engaged during this time so that lower abdomen up and in, keep breathing. And the hand's gonna come down. Great. Front foot comes to meet the back, okay? We're gonna set up for our cat-cows. All right, fingertips spread nice and generously here, okay? And you're gonna shift the hips slightly over the knees, okay? And then find a nice neutral table. Let's hold here for a moment. Bring the head and the neck straight forward, nice and long. Press into the fingertips. Push down into your mat for the beginning. Let's just get this momentum here of this nice sturdy table. Breathe in. Breathe out. So let's just focus on our breathing for a moment as we hold this tabletop, okay? So same ujjayi breath. Breathe in through the nose. All right, exhale out the back of the throat, come. Mouth is sealed gently or either open, whichever is working for you. Okay, let's go ahead into our cat-cow movement. All right, we can kind of ease into these cat-cows. Just shift your right hip over toward the right. Back to center, inhale, over toward the left, exhale. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, over right. Gaze to the left. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, over left, gaze toward the right. Come back to center, inhale. Shift your weight slightly back. Let's just see how the arms feel. Slow, 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 slow. Just let that stretch happen. Come back up. And then let's set up for our cat-cows. So inhale, you're gonna arch the spine, Open shoulders, lift the chin. Exhale, round the spine. All the way to the top of your head, scooping the belly in, chin to chest. Inhale, arch. Exhale, round. Inhale, arch. Exhale, round. Inhale, arch. Exhale, round. Shift the weight back to a child's pose. Take a pause. Get knees and feet together if you'd like here. Just ease on back towards your heels. Hips ease back. Shift side to side, slow. Walk hands out. Forehead comes down slowly. Breathe in. Exhale. Breathe in. Exhale. Same ujjayi breath. Come back to all fours. Inhale. Okay, we're gonna tuck the toes out, okay? You can kind of tap the feet, cups outside. And then just hover the knees slowly. Shift the hips back. Right foot presses into the mat, left foot presses into the mat. Press away from your mat with your hands. Shift the hips up to the sky, breathe. Exhale. Bend the right knee, inhale. Straighten the left. Inhale, bend the left knee. Exhale, plant the right foot firmly down as much as possible. Inhale, bend the right. Exhale, plant the left firmly down. Inhale, bend the left. Exhale, plant the right firmly down. Both feet down, big breath in. Exhale. Bend the knees, walk it up. Down, down, down. At the top of our mat, exhale. Hands are free, head is free. Bend the knees generously if you need to here. Otherwise, straight legs. Tailbone up to the sky. Shift the weight slightly toward the center of the feet. Breathe in. Exhale. Inhale, lift the body halfway. Head and neck nice and straight forward. Exhale, fold down. Hands hang, head hangs, neck hangs. Inhale, lift the body halfway. Hands on the shins or either on the hip points here, you guys. Whatever's gonna just remind you to keep this nice table with your back, okay? Crown of the head straight forward, okay? Hinging at the hips slightly. And then exhale, fold down. Inhale, lift the body halfway, hands on the shins or either the hip points. Exhale, fold down. Inhale, roll up vertebrae by vertebrae, up to standing. Exhale, shoulders up and then down. Beautiful. All right, so we're at the top of our mat. Okay. We're just gonna reach the arms out and up, inhale. Exhale, hands to heart center. Reach the arms down, out and up, inhale. Exhale, hands to heart center. Stepping our right foot back behind us. We're going to take warrior one. So we've got like this 45 degree angle, okay? Back toes slightly out to the side, heel to heel alignment, okay? Torso center, okay? Back thigh squeezing in, front knee bent, okay? Good, arms reaching out to cactus, all right? Core is engaged, so we have the core engagement here. Most of them are scooping the belly in toward the back, but you're not contracting as if you're trying to fit into an outfit or squeeze into something that doesn't fit. You're not doing that. You are just simply being mindful of your core here. So it's a slight contraction of the core, okay? Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, cactus. Good. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, cactus. Bring your chin up with this. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, cactus. Okay. Press really root down into your back foot and your front foot during this. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, arms reach up to the sky. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, cactus. Arms come down, okay? If you needed to take a break when we do the other side, it's fine to straighten and then come back to knee bend, okay? Just want to let you all know that a break is accessible. So we're going to go ahead and lift the back heel, press into the right toes, and just slightly turn the right toes forward, okay? What we're going to do is go ahead and start to bend this back knee, bring our hands down, okay? Front foot comes to meet the back, all right? We'll tuck our toes up. We're going to go ahead and go back to that downward facing dog. Right leg straightens, left leg straightens. Pedal it out, breathe in and out. So right knee bends, left knee straightens. Left knee bends, right leg straightens. Slight bend in the knees, tiptoe it up. Great. Okay. Fold it down. Inhale, roll up vertebrae by vertebrae. The shoulders are going to draw up to the ears. And then exhale, lower them down. We'll do the other side. The left foot steps back. We're in warrior one, okay? So same thing. Back toes slightly out to the side. We've got this 45 degree angle here. Towards the center, okay? Front knee bends. Arms out, cactus, okay? Squeeze the back thigh inward, front knee bends, the right hip shifts slightly over toward the left, reach up to the sky, inhale, exhale, cactus, core is engaged, lower abdomen up and in, okay? Inhale, reach, exhale, cactus, inhale, chin to the sky, gaze up ahead. Chin center, cactus. Okay. Off foot. So just make sure you're pressing into all four corners of your foot. Inhale, reach. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, reach. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, reach. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, reach. Exhale, cactus. Last one, inhale, reach. Exhale, cactus. Arms down. Remember, we're still using that Ujjayi breath, okay? So what we're gonna do here is the same thing, lift the back heel, turn the left toes slightly to face forward, bring the back knee down, front knee comes to meet the back, okay? We're going to shift it back into a child's pose. Open the legs wide as your mat. Okay? Bring your big toes to touch. And then shift your hips back towards your heels slowly as possible. Lock your hands out. Take a big breath in. And then exhale. Inhale, come back to that all fours position. Okay? You go back into warrior one. Tuck the toes out. Hover the knees, shift the hips back, right leg straightens, left leg straightens, pedal it out, right knee bends, left foot presses into the mat, left knee bends, right foot presses into the mat, inhale, bend right knee, exhale, press into the left foot, inhale, bend left knee, exhale, press into the right foot, inhale, bend right knee, press into your fingertips at the top of the mat. Slight retraction of your shoulders. And out and around. hands, like shins. Pause. Bend the knees. Walk it on up top of the mat. Stay low. Yeah. Belly to thighs. Hang here. Knees bent or straight. Exhale. And all the way up to stand. Shoulders draw to the ears. Exhale, come around. And down. Beautiful. So right foot's going to step back again. We're on warrior one. So today's practice is all about warrior one. So we're going to do warrior one again. Okay. The knees bent. Torso center. Okay. Arms reaching out. Back to cactus. Okay. Core is engaged. Inhale, reach it up. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus. One more. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus. So we're still rooting down into our feet here. Okay. Pressing into all four corners of that front foot and back foot. Feel myself like. And so what we want to do is somebody to come and push you. They can't move you from here. Okay. That's how sturdy, firm your feet are. That's how much you're digging into the earth. Okay. The earth is our mat. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus. Arms coming down. Great. All right. So same thing. We're going to lift the back heel, press into the right toes, slowly turn the right foot forward. Okay. And this time we're going to go into a little lunge. I'm going to add on a little bit here. So keep the back toes exactly as they are. Okay. We're bringing the hands together, heart center, elbows out to the side. Pause and breathe. Gaze straight forward into space, maybe to the wall ahead of you or whatever's in front of you. Just find your interest, see your gaze, a place where your eyes just remain in focus and don't move. As you breathe, you feel the pose. Two more breaths. Arms are coming down. Okay, front foot comes to meet the back. We're gonna prep again. In, down, dog, tuck the toes up. Cover the knees, hip shift back. Right leg straightens, left leg straightens. Pedal it up, breathe in and out. Maybe you pedal a little bit faster this time. Hips to the sky, thighs pressing back. Pushing away from your mat with your hands, pressing into your fingertips. Slight retraction of the shoulders to create some space here. Out and around where your elbows and shoulders. Head can move from side to side and up and down. Slide into your knees, tiptoe. Keep going. Exhale. Inhale, roll up vertebrae by vertebrae. Press into all four corners of the feet. Shoulders up and then down. Beautiful. So left foot's going to step back for us. And we're back to warrior one. Okay. Front knee bends. Torso center. Okay. We're going to take that same stance. Lower abdomen is up and in. Engaging the core. Front foot straight forward. Front knee is bent. Arms out to the side. Cactus. Okay. Inhale, reach up. Exhale. Cactus. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, reach up. pressing to the top of the left toes. Lift the left heel. Slowly turn the feet around to face forward. Bring the back knee down. Okay. Tap the left toes. We're in our low lunge. Okay. Hands to heart center. Elbows out to the side. Breathe. Pressing to the top of the back foot or back toes are turned out so that it can work with the ball of the foot. Okay. I like to have the toes under so that I can get into the shin and also this left hip flexor area. I'm going to take two more breaths. Ujjayi, remember breathing in through the nose. Hum on the exhale, lips gently sealed or inner mouth open. Arms are down. Going to frame the front foot with that hand. Coming around. Beautiful. And then what we're going to do is just take a nice little restorative stretch here. Let's come onto our bellies. Great. Arms down beside us. Okay. Let me bring this right knee onto the right outer edge of the mat. Right foot out to the side. And there's a couple of options here. You're going to create a pillow with your hands. All right. Or you can have a pillow with your palms open and your forehead down into your palms. We're gonna stay here for 3 to 4 breaths. Back to your Ujjayi breath. Slower breathing, relax. Great. All right, we're going to go ahead and do the other side, okay, guys? So the right leg is going to come down. We're going to do the left side. All right, so left knee on the left outer edge of the mat. Same exact pose on the other side. Left foot is out to the side. And the same thing, we're going to create a pillow and just rest this way or this way. Okay? Or we're going to have the palms of our hand open and then rest our head into the center. Okay? Take some time. Just relax. And we're going to take 3 to 4 breaths once you get there. The left leg is extended nice and long as the right is lifted. Beautiful work. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and bring this leg down and then let's roll gently onto our back. So just bring that left arm up and we're going to roll onto the side and eventually make our way onto our back. Really just gently and slowly. So remember, a big part of practicing with me is that I like to cultivate us being very gentle with our bodies. Okay, so let's bring our knees to a tabletop position, toes are pointed. Okay. And we're doing the core work here. Y'all ready for this core work? So right elbow to right knee, and then the right leg is going to extend, okay? So here we go. Exhale. Inhale back. Exhale, lift. Inhale back. Exhale, lift. Inhale back. Exhale, lift. Inhale back. Exhale, lift. So drawing that opposite knee in, exhale, elbow to the knee. They're meeting each other halfway, guys, okay? Taking those pauses, because we want to make sure we're breathing. A lot of times, core work is done without breath. Doesn't make any sense to do it, guys. We can't hold our breath. Our muscles need oxygen. Inhale. So make sure you pause, breathe, exhale. Exhales are your crunches, inhale are your rest. last one. Whole time lower back is in our mat, okay? We want to make sure that lower back is grounded, okay? Knees that you're going to draw in, just scoot yourself back on, all right? Let's go ahead and walk the feet in toward our bottom, all right? Just a little bit of bridging. Walk your shoulders in, walk your feet in a little bit more, okay? Kind of gauge where you are today. Clasp the hands underneath you, or hands are down, reaching toward the ankles. Lift the hips to the sky, okay? Pelvis lifts up, lower down, exhale. Inhale, lift. Head centered, exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift the hips, pelvis to the sky. Exhale, lower. This time, lift the hips. Try not to overly squeeze the glutes. See how that feels. Press more into the feet. It's a very different feeling. Relaxing the glutes. Exhale, lower. Next one, squeeze the glutes in. Lower down. All right, we're gonna pause here, okay? Move the hands from underneath you, all right? And you're just gonna lift one leg up to the sky at a time, flex the right foot, flex the left foot, okay? Reach the hand toward the toes, okay? Or either the ankles or calves, and just draw the legs in closer to you for a little bit of a stretch, okay? Hold here. Any of those points that feel good for you to grab. Release the hand from the feet. And just let the legs shoot up to the sky on your own. Flex the toes, okay? Bring your arms out to a T or either cactus or either above your head. Whichever one of those feels good. And just take a moment with your feet up in the air. If you have a wall, if you want to do, put your feet up the wall at home, you can. I'm just here today, just briefly for a moment, 3 to 4 breaths, okay? Eyes closed, back to your ujjayi breath, or either deep breathing or your normal breathing pattern, just letting the breath flow organically. Side or outside of your feet, happy baby, rock side to side. I love happy baby. We'll probably always do happy baby because I think it's so important that we go back to our inner child regularly to just check and see if there's any nurturing that needs to be done back there. Also to find that joy as a baby, as a child, that natural sense of joy we're all born with from day one. And if the discovery is that you don't remember that sense of joy, can you bring that to your baby, to your inner child, to the little girl, the little boy, you in this moment through this practice and say, you are so loved by me now. The grown adult me. Okay? Go back and nurture that child in you. hands on the outside of the knees. Close the legs. Feet are down. And take our shavasana. Feet fall away from each other. Palms facing up. Eyes closed. Shoulders relaxed. Entire body relaxed. Allowing this moment of rest and restoration and self-nurturing to set the tone not only for our Sunday, our week, our month, the days beyond. Make the commitment to be consistent and loving and nurturing and caring for you. And now take this time to relax. Explore the art of doing nothing. Let your breath flow freely. Let your entire body relax. Soften your face. Relax your eyes. Come back into your body, back to your mind, back to this moment. Big breath in. Exhale out. Big breath in. Exhale out. Your ankles outward and in. Relax your feet. And your elbows. Suck your wrists down in. Give thanks for those cracks. Whatever bones if you're feeling those. Bring your knees in. And gently rock side to side. Okay, roll onto your right or your left side. You pick. If you want to do both, you do that too. I'll take a moment and breathe. And gently come up to a seat. Your eyes closed if you're able to. Okay. Come back to your meditative seat from the beginning of practice. Bring your hands into your center of your lap.